Well, happy birthday, Maya. Can you tell us how old you are? Do you want to share?
Seven.
Whoa.
17.
Seven. Excellent. And today is Mr. Chandler's birthday, so you share a birthday.
I'm 37.
Excellent.
I kind of transposed that a little.
Really? You look much younger.
Did you hear the story that was being read in the scripture that Mrs. Clappy read?
No.
Did Marlo?
I read the whole thing.
You read the whole thing. What was the story about? Right, so Paul and Silas, who are two, Paul is one of the people who writes most of what is in the New Testament. He writes a lot of letters to people, explaining to them what Christianity is about and what Jesus wants us to do. But they're thrown in jail because they healed this woman who they thought had an evil spirit. And the reason they threw her in jail is because she was sort of pretending to be a fortune teller, and the people that she was a slave, and the people that owned her made money when she did that. So while they're sleeping, there's a huge earthquake, and the little stocks, have you ever seen pictures of what are called stocks? Can you imagine having to put your feet through some holes of wood, and you can't move because they're nailed to the floor? They had to sleep like that.
Well,
feet locked in
stocks. Stocks, I thought, was like when you put your head in your hands.
Your feet too. Your feet, your hands.
Your feet too.
They would chain them to the wall and they would put their feet in stocks so they couldn't move. So you're kind of immobilized. So imagine there's this earthquake and it all opens right up. And the jailer is very upset. But the jailer soon learns that he's not going to get in trouble because Paul tells him the story of Jesus. And he lets him know that Jesus loves him and his whole family. So they go back to the jailer's house, have some food, and they get baptized, and all ends well. We know about the story of Jesus, right? Mm-hmm. We know that God loved us so much that he sent his son, Jesus. How do we show our love for God?
Loving him.
Loving him. We love because he loved us. It's that simple, Marlo, actually. It's really just that simple. Loving God, but how do we show that we love God? What can we do to let God know that we love him?
We pray.
We pray. What else can we do? Ellen?
Be kind to people.
We can be kind to people.
I was thinking of something that's kind of the same.
Yeah? Well, what's special about today besides it being Maya and Mr. Chandler's birthday? It's Mother's Day. How can we show our mothers that we love them? Marla?
This is about yesterday.
So, but how can we show our mothers that we love them? What can you do to let your mom know that you love her? You saw a sign saying, God bless all moms. What else can we do to let our moms know that we love them? You could say, I love you. Any other ideas? Something that you think would make your mom really happy if you did it? Hug her. Moms love hugs. Absolutely. Anybody else? Okay, Marlon. Cleaning your room. Excellent. Without complaining, she said. Even better. Zach?
Teaching her every single paradox theory in the world.
Teaching her every single paradox theory in the world. Mm-hmm. And I'm sure because your mom loves you, she would listen to every single paradox theory.
You
what?
She went cold.
she might fall asleep.
I actually came up with my own paradox theory about God. If God created everything and Jesus is a human version of God and Jesus is everything, then did God create himself?
That's an interesting topic that we'll have to explore. But I want you to each say one thing. I want you to say something to your mom, Zach and Marlo. I know your mom's not here. But if you had one thing to say to your mom right now, what would it be?
Hi.
Hi, Maya. Hi. Marlo.
I have a zipper on.
Something that your mom would like. It's Mother's Day. What would you like to say to your mom?
Justin?
What?
Justin.
I can't hear you.
Chocolate?
Chocolate. She would like chocolate, I'm sure. Zach, anything you want to say to your mom?
Words.
Well, let's remember what we've talked about. We said if we want to show God that we love him, we do what he's asked us to do. We love other people. And if we want to show our mom that we love her,
we say, I love you.
We say, I love you, but we also do what she's asked us to do.